My name is Joseph Ndiritu, manager in the Enterprise Business Solutions. And I want to take you through the omnichannel customer experience. Now, what we're saying is that the omnichannel customer experience is the new frontier of customer solutions. Back in the days, 20 years ago, customers interacted with brands through a small handful of channels. We had catalog orders. You can see the phone, the old phone there, TV broadcasts, and what you would call billboards of a bank called Goliath Bank. Now, the other ways they used to interact was if they would walk into a call center and maybe for their service issues, and also again, maybe physically. Yeah, if they walk into a bank and they get someone, an agent, to assist them. Coming to this day, what we are saying is omnichannel customer engagement best practices and solutions empower companies to deliver consistent, personalized customer experiences throughout each journey and across all channels and touch points. Now, what we find is that we still have challenges. Yeah, despite omnichannel being the way to go, we still have challenges in that our customers are expecting us to engage with companies on multiple channels and across channels. But as companies, we have challenges synchronizing multiple channels and at the same time within a single journey to deliver the personalized contextual experience each time. So we'll have one agent give a story. After that, it breaks, maybe the call breaks. And when you're back up, you have to repeat the whole story. Conversational interfaces, voice and text, they're the new frontiers of engagement. What we are saying is that messaging to businesses is becoming more common. Mobile presence is therefore a must for your businesses. Companies are looking for ways to engage customers via conversational interfaces. And I'm not talking about mobile apps. Each of us here probably use about 20 mobile apps or so with your smartphones. Yeah. So I'm talking about a way of engaging with your company or the organization, a way that the customer can engage with the organization without having to download an app. So messaging is the killer app. And we have some numbers there. These are provided by Gartner. And what we are saying is that 59% messaging, 59% of messaging will be more now than it was 2 years before. Then 56% will increase messaging over the next 2 years. And there'll be a 63% increased messaging to businesses. In other words, there's a shift from walking into branches. There's a shift from calling branches. I just want to be found where I am, on my Facebook, on my Slack, and I engage there. I can transact there. I can check my balances there. I can do anything there and move on. Now, all this is possible if it's powered by artificial intelligence. That is why the product is running on an Oracle platform, because most of the work has been done. The AI capabilities already done by Microsoft, by Google, by Oracle, all these are in place. So what we are saying, it's cloud first, mobile first, as the most important high level imperative over the next 10 years. Now, to kick off this conversation, we have 6 questions that we want to ask ourselves before we introduce this particular product. How are you engaging with your customers, or with your partners, or with your employees across multiple channels? On the web, messaging, voice, just think about it. Question number 2, how long does it take for customers to connect with your agents? How long does it take to provide the right response? Number 3, how are you taking advantage of messaging apps like Facebook Messenger or Slack to engage customers? Number 4, how are you leveraging social media and messaging apps to reach and hire new talent? For example, if you're a HR and you're here, you could use this particular application or solution to hire new talent. Number 5, have you considered the chatbot or the digital assistant? So basically, the digital assistant is what I'm calling a chatbot. So have you considered the chatbot or digital assistant technology to elevate customer service, employee engagement, or new talent hire, or even sales automation? And number 6, what if a digital assistant could automate mundane business processes and approvals across business functions? Now what I mean is a good example is account opening. Must I walk to the branch to do that? I could do it over a chatbot. So introducing Eclectics Digital Assistant. It's a part of a complete omni-channel cloud platform that will help you engage in intelligent and contextually with your customers, business partners, and employees through end-user channels. It could be on the web, so I just have something introduced, you know, like the way you say, let's chat now on the web. It could be there. I could also be having a voice or through messaging platforms. The Eclectics Digital Assistant is contextual, it is personalized, and it is intelligent. We are saying it is intelligent because it's powered by AI from Oracle. Using it, you access you get to access the customers through the channels that they choose to use, when they decide, where they choose, and how they choose to. That's the customer. That's what they've defined, and that's where they want you to get them. Digital assistance will allow for instant scaled responses to customer inquiries, allowing reps to focus on more complex tasks. So if you had your agent there and focusing on very small issues, yeah, let the chatbot do that and log a case into your CRM system, into your help desk system. Meanwhile, that particular agent can focus on more serious issues. We're also saying digital assistants can understand user intent and main context, allowing for personalized responses to customer inquiries. One of the technologies, I'll not throw a lot of jargon, but it's natural language processing. That's how they're able to learn, yeah? How to best answer your question. And they get brighter over time. They may get brighter than yourselves, by the way. Extending recruiting self-service tools onto mobile messaging platforms. Finally, automating standard business responses and flows through digital assistant skills to reduce costs and increase productivity. I don't have to park so many people in my call center, and I can handle hundreds of customer queries using an intelligent chatbot. Whereas if I was in a call center, what would I be seeing on the screen? Calls dropped each and every time. Now the value proposition, and these are the selling points. First of all, reach more customers anywhere, anytime to increase engagement. The chatbot or the digital assistant is automated, is scalable, has automated interaction 24/7, 365 days a year, and in the channel of your choice. Channel of your choice, I mean, it could be on Facebook, it could be on Twitter, it could be on Slack, and this is where Oracle cooperates with Microsoft, on Microsoft Teams, believe it or not, it's working, okay? Then deliver assistance to the web, Facebook Messenger, Slack, Alexa, and many more. Then you also have rich conversational experiences, including multimedia cards and image carousels. The other value proposition is increase business productivity and growth by accessing intelligence drone from multiple applications. The other thing is build in skills routing seamlessly switches between different app experiences. Then also, you can monitor how many of these, if you build a certain maybe query and it keeps dropping, it means probably there's a problem with the way you built and the way the customer, the way the query is being handled by the chatbot. So it comes with some built-in analytics on how many calls or how many issues it sorted within a certain time, giving you a graph. So it provides cross-channel user behavior and also performance insights. The other proposition, reduce time to market with simplified development. It's really simple. It's visual and declarative design, drag and drop, proactive AI in the digital assistant, and also through that it was named a leader in the 2018 Forrester Wave Digital Experience Development. Another value proposition, create intelligent user experiences to increase customer satisfaction. So it is personalized, even predictive, AI-powered responses to the questions that you ask it. It has built-in support for seamless hands-off to live human agents. This is very important. At the point where it has to drop off, it doesn't just leave you. At least it will send a notification that a human agent is required, like yourselves. Then, of course, it has machine learning capabilities, that's ML. It has also natural language processing support. That's for even the FAQs, frequently asked questions. So how are we addressing customer challenges with the digital assistance? What we are saying is it will help you respond quickly to customer inquiries, scale contact center operations to longer hours, more days. You don't have to have so many people in your contact center anymore. Reduce customer contact center costs. I don't have to have so many agent licenses. I can have the chatbot in place of those licenses. Improve overall efficiencies. Then also serve customers through more channels. Facebook, Alexa, messaging, Microsoft Teams, WeChat, Slack, all those. Ability to innovate quickly and securely. Then extend multiple backend systems simultaneously to different channels. The main features, they are ability to extend multiple backend apps, built-in analytics, low-code development, instant app capabilities within the digital assistant messaging flow, automatic assistant to human agent, that's the hands-off I'm talking about when it's handing over to the when it's handing over to a human agent, then differentiated question and answer user dialogues for if you're maybe creating an FAQ bot, then built-in AI engine with self-learning, deep learning algorithms. Now this is the slide I'm talking about. Please pay attention to what's happening here. So we have the supported channels on this side. We have the Eclectics digital assistant, and it's the one that's interfacing to the skills store. Now the skills store, just take read maybe from the tables that are there, and at the end you have all your backend apps. So where we would be coming in is to configure the Eclectics digital assistant with our ESP and integrated into the ERP, the human capital management, maybe the CX system, any custom systems or third party systems, your CRMs, each and everything. That's what we would be integrating to. So this is where we lie, and that's the strong point. And again, we are saying it's not an app that you're going to download it. No, you're just going to find it here on Slack, Facebook, Microsoft Teams, Alexa, Google Home, and many more. Now, this is a bit technical, but I just wanted to show you how we are doing it. What we have are four key components. A channel configurator, that's where we're just targeting the multiple clients. That's the Facebooks, the WeChat, and the Slacks. Then down here, our connectivity to the backend systems. We have a tool that's the enterprise data integration that's doing that. Then for your dialogues, the flow of how the chatbot will be executed. All the flow, like how are you, what do you want, then you choose the service. All that is done by the dialogue flow execution. Then we also have the conversational AI engine. So what we're saying, it's a Q&A builder. This just shows you how we can build from an FAQ to a bot in very few minutes. Then again, this is just a screenshot to show you the handoff from the agent from the chatbot directly to the agent, and it's a seamless. It needs to be as seamless as possible. Probably even the customer will not notice anything if they don't know. They'll still believe that they are talking maybe to a human agent. Now the visual builder just helps you with your insights. The next screen I think is better. Yeah, so it will show you the completed versus the abandoned conversations. This is for your own internal reporting. It will show you the top intents, the completed and the abandoned ones. It will show you the top channels that are in use, and it will basically also show you the bot performance, the chatbot performance. How is it performing? Maybe it's even taken over your other multi-channel ways of engaging your customers. Then, whoever has developed it internally, they're also able to see what are the problems with the assistant. Because sometimes maybe the flow, the logic could be wrong, yeah? So it also gives you basically a dashboard summary of the bot conversation paths and how they are being executed. You'll find maybe it's slow, and at some point, customers are getting lost along the way. So you maybe need to modify your code or something like that. So all these statistics, it will show you all those statistics. Finally, why Eclectics Digital Assistant? We are saying it's a one multi-channel engagement platform linking user experiences across mobile, web, and digital. One unifying solution, bringing it all together, using the Oracle software as a service on-premise and also third-party systems. It has a powerful conversation AI platform. It's built on the web, on the mobile, and basically you'll find it also on the other channels, the Facebook, the Alexa, sorry. You'll also find it in the Microsoft Teams. So mobile and digital assistant insights, dashboards and tools to understand user behavior or app performance for better development. We have many use cases. I know we are mixed, some are insurance, MFIs. So we try to think of what we could do. And while we have customer queries, at some point you'll say, maybe my card is not working. You're going to log that issue there. It will ask you for your details, or it will also get your details if you have them with a bank. And at some point, it's going to log a system and probably give you a case number if you've integrated it with a CRM solution. Then we have account opening, funding, and balance inquiries. This is the use case that we're going to see how it does it. Then for the insurance, you could also automate the way you make your claims. I know it's a very manual process, maybe if I am making an insurance claim, but we are saying I can use a chatbot, fill in the form, and get to process it if I get my business processes correct. So upon implementation, the anticipated outcome is that any institution's customers are able to log in their requests and have their issues promptly handled. What are we trying to do? We're just trying to have better delivery of service by the staff to customers.